instructions. For account details, press 1. For queries as to said account details, press 2. You've stopped concentrating on the numbers. You're gonna guess and press 3.
Fuck, I'll press 3.
Please wait while we put you through to cancel your account.
Just having a look at things, Sally.
Look, I'm in a bit of a rush, so it...
I'm just having a look at things, Sally. Won't be a minute.
Okay, then.
Alrighty! So, I've had a look at your frozen account, and it seems as though you have made an abnormal purchase.
Abnormal?
Our automated system picks up on card activity that seems out of the ordinary, and the last thing you tried to buy got picked up as abnormal activity.
Oh, great.
So I just need you to tell me the name of the shop that you tried to make your last purchase from and exactly how much that purchase was for.
Well, the shop was Tesco and it should have been about 13 quid.
Oh, I'm sorry. That doesn't seem to be what we have in our system.
What?
Well, I can see that you tried to buy some microwavable chicken tikka masala and some slim lime tonic at Tesco earlier on this afternoon. However, that isn't the purchase that initially blocked your card. In fact, you buy the same variation of ingredients quite often. So really, it's not out of the ordinary at all.
It was blocked before then?
Yes, at a shop called Patterson's Fish Shop.
No.
Yes, I think so.
That little bastard!
Excuse me? Hello? Hello? Sally?
Why are you calling me?
Why do you think?
Dinner? The chicken tikka masala again. Because I want to be honest, I had a weird feeling in my stomach and I don't indulge again.
No, Peter, I was not calling you about dinner. Oh. I know what you did.
You do?
Yes, I do.
Okay, listen. I know you told me I was never allowed to touch Grandma's vase because I might break it, but I'm 17, you know? I just come in from a long day of school and my geography test went badly. I mean, how was I meant to know? It was an open book. So Mr. Griffin shouted at me when he saw I've been using my notes the whole time and he just wouldn't listen to any reason about a misunderstanding. So I get home and I hear the microwave go off and I'm really not in the mood for chicken tikka masala. So I march up the stairs in a fit of rage, only to find the dog had waited in my bin, and then, get this, vomited all over my bed sheets, which I had just put on. So then I thought to myself, how unfair is it that I'm not to go near that vase when I'm basically an adult, and decided to prove myself as a person who is actually able to function in a modern society, and go over and have a look at it. I'm so full of rage and adrenaline from my horrific day that I violently trip and the vase clangs to the floor, cracking right in half, as if to spite me. But Mum, you don't even have to shatter me because nothing you can say will be able to have the same effect as the guilt and the self-loathing. That has been brought about by my inability to do literally anything.
That is not what I was calling you about.
What?
You smashed my mother's vase.
Smashed is a loose term.
You broke my mother's vase.
Nothing like clamps on super clean.
I don't believe this. That vase was our emergency spending money. It's what will pay for your student loan, that is, assuming you even get into university. You have smashed a Ming
more invested in the sentimental value of it than the...
Both ways. I am invested both ways.
It was an accident.
You were an accident.
Dad always said I was a welcome surprise.
That was before you smashed our main vase.
It's not a main vase.
Yes, it is.
No, it's not. It's a story Grandma told you when you were younger for fun. And she never has the heart to contradict the story.
What?
It's fake.
What?
It's fake.
What?
It's fake.
Don't you shout at me like that, young man.
The vase is not real. It is broken, and I'm sorry. But so long as the only value you saw in it was financial, then you cannot be annoyed at me.
I told you not to go near that vase, and you went near the vase. That is the problem.
If I smashed the china duck, would you be annoyed?
I don't know. Maybe. A bit.
But you'd be an exasperated sort of angry. Not a giving birth to you with an unwelcome surprise sort of angry.
You tried to buy more fish. Peter. You can't keep buying goldfish. We can not keep them alive. We have tried and failed so many times, and I just can't bring myself to flush another one down the toilet. Don't you have anything to say?
I didn't buy more goldfish.
You didn't?
No. And you're a bit harsh. I've only ever bought two goldfish, okay? I'm not some mass goldfish fiend. I like to recreate the Saw movies, but with goldfish. In fact, I'm confused as to even why you thought of bought any goldfish.
Because my bank records show that somebody tried to use my card at the fish shop.
You know, they don't just sell fish at the fish shop. I mean, there's all kinds of marine animals. There's eels, there's octopus. There's some even really tiny sharks. Although they're a bit pricey.
Peter, what did you buy?
Why are you assuming
what
that?
Did you buy?
A sea cucumber!
No.
I did. I'm sorry.
How did you even pay for it if the card didn't go through?
Oh, they know me down there, so I don't have to pay up front.
So let me get this right. Out of goldfish and octopus and small sharks, you decided to spend 17 quid on an underwater slug.
17 quid is hardly debt.
You decided to put yourself into debt for the sake of a sea cucumber.
Shh! He's next door. He might hear you.
I don't believe this. How many times do I have to tell you every single fish that you buy dies?
Yes. But this isn't a fish.
This is a slug. You could have gone out into the garden to get a slug. But no, you had to spend 17 quid on an underwater slug.
Well, technically, it's a cucumber.
Peter, why do you keep doing this?
Doing what?
It would be different if you cared for them and were passionate about marine biology or whatever. But you aren't.
I might be.
Name me one fact about sea cucumbers.
Okay. They don't have any legs.
And?
And, they're a bit slimy.
And,
you know what? You didn't know a thing about the main vase that lived in this flat since you moved here. And you aren't banned from having it.
But the main vase meant something to me.
From the sounds of it, the main vase meant money to you, okay? I love my fish.
Peter, I don't want to sound insensitive. Where are your friends? Aren't you supposed to have a few more friends?
Well, not many people want to be friends with me. I'm a fish-toting weirdo!
Oh. Has it ever occurred to you that by giving up the fish, you might slip? slightly improve your social life.
Mum, that was a joke. Nobody knows that I sometimes have underwater creatures in my bedroom. Okay, there's a rumor going around school about Peter the Weirdo with the fish. Nobody pays enough attention to me for that.
Oh.
It's like they're all... So they're all penguins in the Arctic, all huddled together. But I'm the one that has to bear the cold.
You're being melodramatic.
It's true. It's stupid, but it's true.
Is that why you buy the fish? Because you feel lonely?
No.
No?
No, Mum. Fish don't speak.
Then why?
Because they're loaded with nutrients and protein. That's more than can be said for your chicken tikka masala.
You eat the fish.
No! That was another joke.
Why won't you give me a straight answer?
Because you won't want to hear it.
Honestly, as long as you're not frying them up and eating them, at this point I'll accept anything.
It's for a project.
What kind of project?
A school project.
Stop being mysterious. It doesn't suit you.
Trying to use it to get into university.
Explain to me how a sea slug can get you into uni.
Sea cucumber.
Oh, whatever.
Obviously, I don't have the grades to go next year, but I thought you made a really interesting project on sea cucumbers that might let me into one of their biology courses or something.
You want to go to uni next year?
I need a change of scene.
Why haven't we discussed this before?
Well, you said it yourself. I don't have any friends.
Well, can't you go to college to get the grades?
Close. I want to go further away. I want out of this fish tank.
Oh, go to a further away college then. You could get the bus.
But I like the sound of university. And I actually emailed a couple and they're interested in my sea cucumber project. Who knows? Maybe I could actually make it in there.
But you would still be living here.
No, Mom. I can't. Sometimes I feel like a walking model. I don't get out and prove to myself that I can coexist with this disaster that... My brain is going to explode.
Why has none of this come up before?
Because I thought you'd be sad.
What made you think that?
You cried for 3 hours the last time you had to flush away one of the goldfish. And I assume I mean slightly more to you than that.
Of course you do. Goldfish don't complain about the chicken tikka masala I cook for them.
Cook is a strong word.
Don't be ungrateful. You'll miss me when you're gone.
When is a strong word.
Well, you want to go to university, so we'll find a way for you to go. Now leave me in peace and play with your sea slug or something.
Okay. How long till dinner?
You can make your own if you don't like my curry.
No, that's okay. I can manage for a few more months.
Leave before you anger me further.
Okay. Okay.
You have reached Clydesdale Bank. You know what to do.
To
please.
please wait while we put you through to Derek? Unblocking my card.
Okay, no problem at all. I'll just be a moment or two. Whoa! Okay, while I'm at it, would you like me to cancel the payment for the sea cucumber?
No. Unblock the card and pay for the cucumber.
No problem at all. 1 minute, please.